Hello everyone, welcome to the cloud network. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to install your body Linux that is in your virtual box. So I'm going to show you how to install. You can find in my channel that how to install your virtual box, that is latest version. You can find here is my virtual box and here is my ISO image which I have already downloaded. The link you can find this all links and the commands you can find below to my video in the description box. So here is I am using latest version of this body 3.10, that is 64 bit. This one you can also install 32 bit supported. And after installing the virtual box, you need to click on new, then you need to type here your body, and then you need to assign. I'm assigning the version. Then you need to select here type, go to Linux, and then you need to select your from here. So you need to select this one, Linux 2.603x4x 64 bit. If you did not get in a virtual box 64 bit options, just you need to enable the virtualization options. You need to go to your system or the laptop whichever using. You need to go to into BIOS mode and you need to there enable the VTX mode, that is virtualization mode. You need to enable. After that it will come here 64 bit option. So select this option and just click on next here. This is the RAM size which I am assigning for this installation. Here I am giving maximum around 4 GB. So you need to give in the limited around the green line. So this is the red line, that is not, we have to go beyond this one. So click on next. So this video I'm going to create a hard drive now. The next, then click on next. Okay, next. This is the location where it's going to be stored in your laptop, desktop or the server. So if you want to change it, you can change the location. And this is the size which you want to assign for this body Linux, for this hard disk size. That means you can assign storage purpose, you can say this one. So you can assign at least your 25 GB or 30 GB according to your purpose. So after I change the locations, clicking to next, create it now. I need to go to the settings here, and then after that, so here you can go to the systems and check floppy, and just you need to check the CD, optical drive and CD drive. I need to go to processor, check this box, and once you can see, this is your acceleration here. You need to enable VTX AMD for 64 bit option also. This also you need to enable this one also. Plus you need to go to your storage, click on empty, then you need to click on small right side on icon CD icon. You need to choose your hard drive where you have downloaded your ISO image. So here is my body Linux which I have downloaded. Double click and go to direct network, click on your bridge adapter so that you can access the internet. Just click to OK it, and then you have to click on start it now. On the screen you can see this is one is live boot installation. That means it's going to be just used as a live boot. It does not install in your desktop or the laptop. So for this purpose, it going to be you can access only this live boot. For the installation, you can go and press and enter this one. So this is going to be installed in a graphical mode. So just select the option and press and enter. So you can see this loading. So just all those not coming. So on the screen you can see we came to on browser. This is going to be connecting, installing the software. Just close this one. So you can see this is a live mode. We can say for this live mode using accessing Mint. Just close this one. Let me close from here. Yeah, come up this one. So here you can see this is live mode. Go to now to install the body, just come up here on icon and click on this install. Body either you can see on screen, so it's buffering. Need to wait. So on the screen you need to click on the continue. So here is showing the best recipe and show this that computer has a 4 GB space available and plug antenna is connected. So just click to continue here. So here you can see this other type of installation is there. Either you can do is you want to completely erase your hard drive or the drives you want to, if you want to completely format, just check this box. Or else if you want to have something else, means you can give your manually partitions, that you need to choose the multiple partition for this body. So before formatting, please take a backup of your data, whatever you have. So just click to install now. And for the confirmation, you need to just go to continue, or you can go back and do the changes on your selecting the options on this something else. You need to select your time zone and click to continue. And the please remember, it's need to be have connected internet, that's compulsory. And now we need to name this here username. I'm giving the cloud, and here I'm giving cloud network, okay. And I'm giving the password here. So you need to give a strong password, and automatically logging here required. And the click on continue. Now you can see on the screen is copying the files. If you want to view the files copying, click on this arrow. Just on the screen you can see that's going to be installing the post installations. You creating the username already have been done. So basically I do not have a current internet, so with this skipping internet installing these Baudel Annex. So here you can see the installation has finished. Continue testing, you can continue the testing, or if you want to restart, you can restart it now. And I'm going to just restart it now so that I can make you up to a full screen resolution. I will show you after restart. Now on the screen you can see showing that if you have installation CD or the pen drive, please remove that one and then continue. So what you have to do is just press and enter. It's loading. So now on the screen you can see we need to log in here with the username, the password which we have given. Now so on the screen you can see this is your Baudel Linux. This is, you can see start menus there, applications where you can find. This is your shutdown, restart, and this is your sound, battery, this is your internet. So basically I'm now going to show you full screen resolution. So you can see this is not a full screen resolution. For that one you need to go to on your VirtualBox devices, just install this insert guest edition CD image, just click on that one and it's going to be come up with your installation here. And to check again. Yes. So like to force it. Alright. After clicking that once, just you need to go to your folder, go to start menu, and then places click on home. Once you come up with the home, and you need to click on this icon. Here is your to run this VirtualBox there, and to run double click on this one, execute in terminal. Okay, fail to execute. Maybe something. I got a point here why this is not installing. Means because of internet is not available in my laptop, so that's why I was not getting this full screen resolution error. You can install this one that I've shown you. Just double click on this one and it's going to come up with the installation starting procedure will come, and after that you need to have internet is compulsory for that one. So that's why this is not working. So please just install, and after that installation you restart it and it will become with your full screen resolution. So here is the end of my video here about the Linux. So for the complete more videos, you can subscribe to my channel IT Cloud Net, that is Cloud Network. So thank you for watching IT Cloud Network. Please subscribe to Cloud.